Hello everyone, in this video tutorial, we are going to discuss about the script for creating the time series neural network in MATLAB. So I have already written the code. Let's look into the brief overview of this code. So first we are importing the dataset. This is the inbuilt dataset available in the MATLAB. In this we have the number of patients diagnosed with the chickenpox. Each time set represents the number of months. And after that we are plotting the data. Then we are converting the data in the form of cell. Then we are creating the open loop network. There are three types of time series network. First is open loop, second is closed loop, and the third is time delay network. In open loop network, we are supplying the actual input and the target to the neural network to predict the next time step value of the target series. So as this is the case of non-linear autoregressive model, we only have the target series available and no input series is there. So in case of open loop non-linear autoregressive model, we are supplying the actual target series to predict the next future value. And in the second case, that is closed loop network, the predicted output is used as the input to the neural network for predicting the future time step of the time series. Then we have the time delay net. So in this case, we can predict the one time step ahead prediction of the current time step. So let's say we have currently time t and we want to predict the outcome or the future value at time t plus 1. So we can do this with the help of time delay series. In this, we remove one delay from the feedback or input. So let's run this code. So after the network is trained, the training window will look like this. So let's look at the regression plot. As we can see, the values are near to 90%. Let's see if we can improve it by looking into the error correlation plot. As we can see, the autocorrelation between the error is considerable at a lag of about 12, and other than that or after that we can see that these values lie within the confidence limit. So let's change the lag value and retrain the network. So after retraining the network, we obtain the regression value that is little bit higher than the previous one, and also the error autocorrelation plot shows that this lag is suitable for our network. So let's look into the code a little bit deeper. These lines are already discussed. In this, I have converted the matrix into the cell. Then I have selected a training function as Bayesian regularization. And this is the feedback delay. I've already discussed how this 12 came up. Let's choose the number of hidden layer as 1 and the number of neurons in it as 10. Now, nanet is the inbuilt MATLAB function for creating the non-linear autoregressive time series network. So in this, I supplied the feedback delays, hidden layer size, and the training function. Open means that I am keeping the network as open. Now, created the network, so I need to prepare this network so that it can be trained. So for that, I have given the feedback delays. So this should be transferred into the input data we have. So prepare TS, that is prepare time series, is the inbuilt MATLAB command for doing so. So I provide the network. As there are no inputs, so this is an empty cell. And T is the target. So X is the new input, T is the new target. And XI and AI represents the input delay state and the feedback delay state respectively. Let's look into these variables. These are the 5 variables I have opened. So T was our target series. As you can see, there are 498 values. And I have provided a delay of 12. So 498 minus 12, that is 486 values will be in the input series. As this is the open series, so there will be no feedback delays. So that's why it's an empty cell. And the remaining 12 value that you have seen, these first 12 values will be stored in this XI. And this is called input delay state. And this is the target series. As you can see, the target and the input series are same. This is the property of the nonlinear autoregressive time series. We are predicting the future value at that time step only. So that's why these two contain the same values. Next, I have provided the divide function as divide indices. You can also provide as divide block. So these two divide functions should be used in case of time series network. Let us keep a divide mode as time. Now I provide divide indices. So these are the indices that I am dividing dataset into. I have kept the performance function as the mean square error. And finally, I train the network by providing in the input X, the target T, the input delay state XI, and the feedback delay state AI. Then I calculate the output of the network by supplying the net with the value of X, the input delay state and the feedback delay state. In this, I multiply the train target or the training values, the validation value and the test value with their respective mask. So this helps in removing the bad values from the data. And then finally, I calculate the performance with respect to each of these divisions. So this was the open loop network, and this looks like this window. Now we need to close the network if we want to predict the outcome of the series from the network itself. If we need to get the continuous supply of the output, because in closed network or the closed loop series, we will be using the predicted value of the network as the input. So as you can see, this is connected to the input that goes to the input delays of 12 and further to the hidden layer. Now you can view the open loop network by clicking on view net. And this is how you close the network, by using the inbuilt MATLAB command close loop. So after this, the network is closed and you can view the network. You can also retrain the closed loop network if the performance of the closed loop network is not as per your expectation. So the same prepare TS, that is prepare time series command, will be used. This time we are using the network closed loop and supplying the target value T and obtaining the various parameters. And then obtaining the performance by comparing the output of the network and the actual target value. In the command window, we can see the test performance for the open loop as this, and the for closed loop, the performance is this. So the performance is the mean square error. And as we can see, for the closed loop performance is comparatively higher as compared to the open loop. And this should be obvious as the network is feed in with the predicted values, and these predicted values contain the error, and this error keeps on getting accumulated, which will lead to the worse results. So the performance of the closed loop network is always less than the open loop network. Sometimes we might require to do the multi-step prediction. So what we might do is we keep on training until we have data in the open loop. And after the data is finished, we convert the network to the closed loop using the closed loop command, and then get the number of future prediction we want. Let's say we want 20 future prediction. So we create an empty cell provided to the closed loop network with the parameters as these. And after this, we can plot the results. This shows the plot that I was discussing right now. So blue line is the open loop network, and this black line shows the performance for 20 time steps. As you can see, it is trying to follow the pattern. Next we have step ahead prediction. So as I've already discussed, sometimes we may require to predict the value at the time step T plus 1 when we only have the input at time step T. So in that case, what we do is remove the input delay and the feedback delay. So this can be obtained by using the inbuilt MATLAB command remove delay and providing the network. So this network step ahead prediction will be created. And in a similar way, we prepare this network and calculate the step ahead performance. As you can see, the performance of step ahead is shown in the command window, and it is comparable to that of the open loop network. So this is what this type of neural network will look like. Earlier we had delays from 1 to 12, and now we reduce the delay, so it is 0 to 11. So this was the case for non-linear autoregressive model. If we have input time series as well as the target time series, then we will be using the NARCS time series model, that is non-linear autoregressive with external input. In that case, we will also have the input delay state. You can study those parameters just like I discussed right now for the NARCS net model. Few things to note. If closed loop network is not performing good, then you need to retrain the closed loop network. Note that if you are using just random values, then you will only have the correlation at lag equal to 0. But in real life situations, most of the data is related lag version of itself. So be sure to check the autocorrelation and find the significant delays and get good amount of training dataset. Now let us look at the Simulink model for all the three networks that we have created. So type Jensen net, and this will open up the Simulink diagram for the open loop network. This is similar to that of data fitting. In this case, the delays are there. So as you can see, I provided 12 delays, so there are 12 delay blocks. So what delay does is to hold the sample for one time period. You can look more about the delay block in the Simulink documentation. Type generate Simulink net C, And as you can see, there is only target available. So in this case also, there are 12 delays available. And we can see that the output that the layer 2 is giving is getting feedback to the layer 1 at the same time. Type generate Simulink at S. In this case, we remove one delay. So as it should be obvious, we have delays from 0 to 11. For all the three networks, the same operation occurs that we have discussed in the Simulink diagram of the data fitting neural network. So that's it everyone. This is it for this tutorial. Hope you like it. And please like, subscribe and share. Thanks for watching.